Hello and Namaste everyone. Welcome to my channel SigmaX. Today, we are learning about solving a mathematical problem related to DE-MOIVRE'S theorem. Is there DE-MOIVRE'S theorem? Using DE-MOIVRE'S theorem, find the cube roots of unity. Also, show that the sum of the three cube roots of unity is zero. Before solving this problem, first of all, let's learn the polar form or the trigonometrical form of a complex number. We know that a complex number can be written as z equals to x plus iy, which can be represented by a point pxy on a complex plane as shown in the figure. Here, x and y are real numbers and x is called the real part of z whereas y is called the imaginary part of z. In complex plane, where x-axis represents real axis and y-axis represents imaginary axis, draw a line PM perpendicular to x-axis OX and join OP. Let OP equals to R and angle POX equals to theta. Then, in right angle triangle OPM, we can write cosine of theta equals to OM divided by OP, which is equal to X divided by R, or X equals to R cos theta. And sine of theta equals to PM divided by OP, which is equal to Y divided by R, or Y equals to R sine theta. Substituting the values of X equals to R cos theta and Y equals to R sine theta in Z equals to X plus IY, we get z equals to r times cos theta plus I sin theta, which is the polar form of complex number. This polar form can be represented by an ordered pair r theta, where r equals to under root x square plus y square, which is actually the modulus of complex number z, and theta equals to tan inverse y divided by x, which can be called as the argument or the amplitude of a complex number and is denoted by argz or ampz. Remember, since sine function and cosine function are periodic with period 2π radian or 360 degree, the complex number z equals to r times cos theta plus I sin theta can be generalized by adding 2π n to the amplitude theta in radian measure or by adding 360 n to the amplitude theta in degree measure. Here, n is the set of integers. Now, let's state DE-MOIVRE'S theorem. It states that for any positive integer n, r times cos theta plus I sin theta whole to the power n equals to r to the power n times cos n theta plus I sin n theta. Actually, DE-MOIVRE'S theorem is true for any integers. The most important uses of DE-MOIVRE'S theorem are to solve equation of higher degree and to find nth root of complex number. Note that for any non-zero complex number z equals to r times cos theta plus I sin theta and positive integer n, the n distinct roots of z are given by the complex number with r to the power 1 by n as its modulus and 360k plus theta divided by n as its argument. Here, theta is in degree and the values of k range from 0 to n minus 1. Now, before finding the cube roots of unity using DE-MOIVRE'S theorem, let's learn the working rule to find nth roots of a complex number. First of all, express the complex number in polar form, z equals to r times cos theta plus I sin theta. We know that to convert z equals to x plus iy into polar form, we should find modulus r by using the formula r equals to under root x square plus y square and amplitude theta by using the formula theta equals to tan inverse y divided by x. Remember, you can calculate amplitude theta either in radian or degrees, but I prefer calculating it in degree. In step number 2, generalize the polar form by adding 360k to the amplitude theta. If z equals to r times cos theta plus I sin theta is the polar form of the complex number z, then its generalized form can be written as z equals to r times cos 360k plus theta plus I sin 360k plus theta. Now, in step number 3, apply DE-MOIVRE'S theorem to generalized equation to find nth roots. If we apply DE-MOIVRE'S theorem to the generalized equation of complex number z, then we get zk equals to r to the power 1 by n times cos 360k plus theta divided by n plus I sin 360k plus theta divided by n, where the values of k range from 0 to n minus 1. And finally, in step number 4, find the first root, second root and similarly nth root by putting the values of k from 0 to n minus 1 respectively. That means, if you want to find first root, then put k equals to 0. If you want to find second root, then put k equals to 1. And similarly, if you want to find nth root, then put k equals to n minus 1. That is, 1 less than the denominator of the given index 1 divided by n. In this way, if we apply these working rules, then we can easily find the nth roots of a complex number. Now, let's find the cube roots of unity by applying these working rules. Here, we are given complex number z equals to 1. Do you know? Every real number is a complex number, but every complex number is not a real number. Therefore, 1 is also a complex number. In step number 1, we are told to express the complex number in polar form, so that comparing z equals to 1 with respect to z equals to x plus iy, we get x equals to 1 and y equals to 0. Now, putting the values of x and y in under root x squared plus y squared and tan inverse y divided by x, we get modulus r equals to 1 and amplitude theta equals to 0 degree. Hence, the polar form of given complex number is z equals to cos 0 degree plus I sine 0 degree. Similarly, in step number 2, we are told to generalize the polar form of given complex number by adding 360k to its modulus. Following the procedure, the generalized form of z can be found as z equals to cos 360k plus I sine 360k. Now, in step number 3, we are applying DE-MOIVRE'S theorem to the generalized form of complex number z. Since we are asked to find cube roots, n becomes 3. Therefore, zk equals to cos 360k divided by 3 plus I sine 360k divided by 3, which gives us zk equals to cos 120 degree times k plus I sine 120 degree times k, where k equals to 0, 1 and 2. Now, in step number 4, putting the values of k equals to 0, 1 and 2 in zk, we are going to find the cube roots of complex number z. Putting k equals to 0, we get first root z0, which is equal to 1. And putting k equals to 1, we get second root z1, which is equal to minus 1 plus root 3i divided by 2. Similarly, putting k equals to 2, we get third root z2, which is equal to minus 1 minus root 3i divided by 2. Note that the complex cube roots of unity are denoted by omega and omega square respectively as omega equals to minus 1 plus root 3i divided by 2 and omega square equals to minus 1 minus root 3i divided by 2. Now, to complete our answer, we should add all 3 cube roots of unity and so that its sum becomes 0. Therefore, adding the cube roots of unity, we get 1 plus omega square equals to 1 plus minus 1 plus root 3i divided by 2 plus minus 1 minus root 3i divided by 2, which gives us 0. Hence, the sum of cube roots of unity is 0. In this way, using DE-MOIVRE'S theorem, we can calculate the cube roots of unity. I hope from now on all of you can find the nth roots of any complex number. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, then please don't forget to like, comment, share and subscribe to my channel. And also don't forget to press the bell icon so you can get notification when I upload a new video. I will see you guys in my next video. Till then, bye bye.